Hi, welcome back to the Spring Security Framework course. Till now we have completed this 9 videos related to this particular Spring Security. So if you haven't watched all these videos, I strongly recommend it. Just go through my channel, you will find this playlist here, and I have attached all the videos in under this playlist. Okay, so without waste time, let me start this video. So we will gonna cover all this in memory detail manager and JDBC detail manager in this video. After this, we will configure our database, and on the basis of that database user information, we will try to put a authentication on that. Okay, yeah, so come here. I am already here into ORG Spring Framework Security Provisioning in package, and in memory user detail manager, it comes under this package and it implements user detail manager. So it implements that user detail manager, of course, then it is a responsible to giving an implementation for all the methods which present inside this user detail manager, right? And it implements one more interface, that is user detail password service. We will talk about it later. Okay, so we have some constructor and we have some method here. So we have our well-known create user method. Before putting a user, it apply the assertion. After that, it will say, okay, whatever the you are passing a user name, it is a key, because see on a top at line number 56, it is a maintaining the hash map, that's name a user. So we have already seen in a theoretical chapter, like it's a maintaining a hash map to putting your user details, right? So whatever the user in, like user get username and user, okay, and it will say, okay, whatever the details it, it will as a value, and whatever the username it, it is as a key. So delete user, it will take a user name, and for the username everywhere it is using a lowercase this function, because it will it is treating everything as in a lowercase. Okay, for all the method whatever the present in user detail, that it giving a concrete implementation. Okay, user like update user, exist user. So in exist user we have this hashmap function that contains key. So like username to lowercase, it will checking like if you have that key, then return that. Okay, and we have our well-known method where it is load by username. Okay, now I not think so, like we need to discuss this again and again, we have learned about it a lot of times. Okay, so we have all these methods and these concrete implementations. So this is a Spring Framework, a Spring Security Framework provided implementation. If your application is small, you don't want to be give your implementation, then you can use in memory detail manager, which we already use in our application here. Okay, so I will, we will discuss about this code when we discuss all these JDBC and in memory, then it will make more sense. Okay, so we have completed this in memory user detail manager. Now come to the JDBC detail manager. It also available this same package, that is provisioning, okay, security, and it extend that JDBC DAO IMPL and implements user detail manager. Okay, so our main focus is user detail manager and group manager. I will talk about in this video only what is this group manager, because it's a bit important. Okay, so this is a production grade functionality, because it has a lot of functions, a lot of methods which you can use easily in your real-time application, in your projects when you are working with some company, right? Because like suppose you are setting a database, and with the help of that whatever the information, user information in your database, you are trying to put authentication on that. So it is, this is a JDBC user detail is a production grade thing. Okay, so you can use there. So now come here, as you can see, we have some variables and we have our methods implementation here, like create user. So what it is doing here, okay, let me tell you, it is using JDBC template to perform all the CRUD operations. What are the persistence operations related to like database, either it is like storing a object or retrieving a object. Okay, so it is using with the help of JDBC template, it's doing all these things. Okay, so we have this implementation here, update user implementation here, okay, delete user implementation here, and one more thing let me show you here. Okay, so if have this create SQL, and create SQL, you can see here we have this particular variable, whatever the value it is, we are assigning to the create SQL, and what the value it, here it is, let me copy this and search. Okay, yeah, as you can see here, what are the value is insert into user with username, password and enabled. Okay, values, we are passing these three values. So one point to be remember here, if you are using this JDBC user detail manager, you need to configure your database, and inside that database your table should be named as users and your column should be named as username, password and enabled. Okay, otherwise this functionality will not work, because Spring Security Framework automatically gonna look and it will try to fetch, okay, whatever the details present inside your database, like it is the table you are using the proper appropriate name, the user or column, whatever the name, it is expecting that. Okay, if you not use that, it will not work. Okay, so as in terms of detail delete, so it is following the pretty good programming here. Like first it is declaring all the final here, because as you check also here, it is declaring all the variables as a final, because we need to not need to change it again and again, because always Spring Security Framework follow this particular architecture. So it is first looking into it, we are declaring it as a final, and whatever the operations like select, delete, we are doing like this. And then when you come down, it assigning another variable to it, like delete SQL user and create all these. And whenever we need this, we are performing here, because we don't need to write that query again and again, right? Yeah, so that's why it is doing here with the help of this. You see update SQL. So let's go here, and whatever the value it is, copy and let's search. So as you can check here, update user set password, right? Whatever the value you will pass, it will check like this. Okay, I hope this is clear to you, like what is a JDBC user, I forgot whatever the this, what is the name, okay, JDBC user detail manager. Okay, yeah, so now this thing is completed. So I want to show you one thing here, that is we have in load by username implementation in our this particular in memory user detail manager class, right? I showed you here load user by username. So I want to show you like it will execute or not, because whenever you are up and running your application with this Spring Security Framework, this is a default implementation which we are using in this our details, right, in this code. So it will always come and run this particular detail load user by username. So let me show you. I will put in the breakpoint here and I will say okay, run my application debug as a Spring Boot. Okay, so my debugger is on. I have debug, right? Yeah, let me go to the localhost and I will say come down balance, so admin, and password is 1234. As you can check here, it will stop at where is my console, come here at the method at line number 147 where I have put the breakpoint, right? It stopped here. So let me press fade, and you can see the output, your balance is this much, right? So we have completed pretty much everything in theoretical way and in coding way. From the next upcoming videos, we will set up our database and we will try to put authentication on the basis of that. Okay, so till then I will see you in next video. Take care, bye bye.